Hello and welcome back to another Smoke Signal Synopsis. In this video, I'll be previewing what's in the February 1st, 2021 edition of the Smoke Signals newspaper. If you check out the front page, you'll see three stories. The first story on the left shows the tribe received good COVID-19 funding news. The CARES Act funding received in March of 2020 has been extended another year. Previously, the Act specified that all the funds had to be used by the end of 2020, which many tribes were struggling to find long-lasting, beneficial ways to use that money. You can read the full story, including how much Grand Ron received and how they've been using the money, continued on page 7. The second story, back on the front page, is about the technology upgrade in the Tribal Council Chambers. Council Chambers 2.0 includes a room scheduling system, electronic sign, and video conference system to better help council members participate remotely. More can be read on page 9. At the bottom of the front page, we have a story about on-time graduation rate of Native students taking a small dip. According to recent Oregon Department of Education numbers, the 2020 rate dropped 0.5%. Putting that into perspective, these numbers are coming from a time when the world was facing a pandemic, so these dips were not unexpected. You can read the rest of the story on page 8. On the second page, we have a small blurb about the Grand Ron Health and Wellness Clinic has started vaccinating tribal members ages 55 and older. You can call 503-879-2032 to schedule your vaccination appointment. Moving on to page 5 and over to the city of Kaiser, the fast food chain Chick-fil-A has applied for a site permit at the Chamawa Station, which is jointly owned by the Confederated Tribes of Grand Ron and the Confederated Tribes of Tsleil-Waututh Indians. On the other side of that page, Tribal Council approves the Yoda Logging Unit during the Wednesday, January 27th meeting. The Yoda Logging Unit will feature 10 cutting blocks totaling 127.6 acres with an estimated yield of 6,403 million board feet. The estimated net revenue of this unit is slightly less than $2.4 million. You can probably guess where the name originated for this unit, but if not, you can check that out on page 5. The Clackamas Community College Board of Education approved naming its under-construction Welcome Center after the Wachino family during its Wednesday, January 20th meeting. You can read the history of Dan Old Man Wachino, his direct descendants on Tribal Council, and the building purpose with pictures on page 6. On page 9, we have the first reopening dates for first and second graders in Willamina School District set for February 9th. You can read the full story on the student's hybrid schedule and the teacher vaccination plan. For our last story, we have the Portland Metro $750,000 grant supporting efforts to acknowledge the native history of the area. This grant is for a proposed center for tribal nations and a waterfront education park at the OMSI district on the eastern shore of the Willamette River. You can read that full story on page 13. And that was your Smoke Signal synopsis. You can read the entire paper in the PDF version online now at smokesignals.org, or you can wait for the print edition coming to you soon. I'm Kamaya, the social media digital journalist for Smoke Signals.